Good evening all. I guess I'm lucky enough to get the last words of the night, even though Warren will probably say something. I sat down last night at home to write a speech, and that was a waste of time, really. The boys were playing Xbox, having some beers, the spa was ready. But I thought I'd better try and put something down, so excuse me if it goes all over the place, but I'll do my best. Although I'm a teacher and speeches as part of the curriculum, I often find it hard to write speeches, so last night I decided I'd fold back to something that I feel most comfortable, I guess, when it comes to speeches, and that is an after-match speech at a rugby club. So, I'm not saying there's two different teams here, because there's two families and they're both amazing, so please don't get me wrong, but away I go. As it normally happens. Firstly, I'd like to thank everyone who got here safely. That's all of you sitting here. It's amazing to be able to share this day with you. And we both, my wife and I, are extremely happy and humbled to be in your presence. That extends out to the people that travelled so far. Whether it be from Britain, or whether it be from Sweden, Canada, France, America. That means a lot to have you here, and we appreciate all the effort you've gone to for us. It makes us feel very special, and we really appreciate it. To the opposing team, not that you're the opposition, the Harrisons. Firstly, Pete, thank you very much for your kind words earlier this evening. Good to know I was a bit different. I've never been someone who wanted to be put in just your average Joe jar, I guess. And I'm glad I proved myself. Thank you for allowing me to marry your wonderful daughter. It's amazing to have gone through today, so thank you very much. Thank you for your kind words. And if I can live my life like you, and have a heart like you, and have patience like you, I think I'll become a better person, so thank you. To Kay, a very amazing, talented lady. Thank you for everything you've done. Thank you for allowing your crazy little girl to decide she wanted to do the whole wedding by herself from start to finish. Thank you for riding the wave with her and telling her that although you've never done half the stuff you've done, you'd do it and it would be fine. And like everyone else here, amazed at what you've done with the cake, the flowers, all your cutting, everything you've done. You're an amazing person. And I really am proud to call you my mother-in-law, so thank you. To Matt, Doro, Craig, Anna, and Liz, I feel very lucky to be part of your family now, and to the extended Harrison family. You know, I look forward to sharing many more memories and experiences with you. So, as you may know, my family, if I've been a dick, please tell me. I don't take offence to it. It's a good wake-up call, so thank you. you'll see why I don't thank Sam shortly. just before I move on to the home team, my team, although it's different. I just thought if Kay doesn't mind, because I know a lot of people have been asking about her, and everyone's come and looked at it. The cake over on the right was a surprise, dare I say it. Aaron didn't want it to be a surprise, but Kay made it happen. She says she did, but deep down, everyone knows she did. That's some 4 tiers. I used to make cakes ages ago, so I know this stuff. It's 4 tiers. I won't go over there because the sound will go nuts, but I'll point. It was the bottom tier, if you have a look at it, is to represent our school days. So Erin's got a paintbrush because she succeeded in every subject, but obviously painting was her forte or art. Obviously, as you've heard tonight, amazing athlete I was. Been asked to sign up by many professional teams, including Roy's Stick Team in France, for the hat, that's me. So that's our school days. The second tier is from our profession. So you'll see Erin has fairy wings for her amazing company, Creative Mischief. Hit it up, you know, do whatever you do, whatever, get involved. I'm obviously a part-time, full-time facilitator, child daycare, however people want to say it, you just do it for the holidays, I don't know, but I'm a teacher, so that's me. The third tier is to symbolise our amazing engagement, which was capped off with an amazing opening World Cup win. Amazing. But the engagement was obviously, hands down, the best part. The fourth part is today, obviously, caps it all off, makes it amazing, and it's Erin and I. So thank you very much, Kate. It's a lovely cake. And there's four eggs under the two birds on top of the Thank you, Mum.
We're just babysitting. Yeah.
The home team, the Skeins. It's a pleasure to be part of a group of amazing individuals. A special group of people that I'm obviously very fortunate, but they're probably more fortunate than me to be part of. blessed to have amazing parents. Never sub off the starting window. Even though Dad would probably be buggered by half time. He'd probably just want to hit the piss after. Led by parents, and then have amazing siblings who I probably don't think enough, even though one of them's Sam. but obviously, amazing people. I'm very proud to be a Skeen. I'm very proud to bring her into the family. Thank you very much for all you do. Siblings as a referee, I guess I could thank them. I think finally for one game in our life we've been blessed to have seen such great officials up here on the front table. Erin and I have been very lucky to have such wonderful bridesmaids, beautiful too I might add, and not so bad advice. Yes. We've been very fortunate to have such a great team with us and look after us over the last 24 hours. If not longer. Thank you to all of you for looking after Erin over the past little while. Thank you for the hens night last Saturday. She had an amazing time. Yeah, she just had more. Thank you, Liz and Claire and Julia and Alice and Vicky for organising that part as well. That means a lot to her that she'd go out and have a ball, and that she did, so thank you very much. And you look amazing, so thank you. To these four idiots. thanks for being here. Thanks for the awesome stag, Mike. although you're a bunch of immature guys, you're not too bad. What can I say? If I was going anywhere, I'd definitely ring you all up and invite you along for the ride, even though one of you comes from Hamilton, which is not the sporting capital of New Zealand, by the way. You keep telling yourself that, mate. Honestly, boys, thanks for all the help. Thanks for all the support. Thanks for all the texts. Thanks for all the not listening. Really appreciate it.
Good job, buddy.
I know I've been talking a bit long. I'll try and wrap it up very quickly. But a special thanks to my man here, Roy. Nice to know someone on the other side of the world will answer a phone call and shoot on over. Beggars Club for a week off work. Big thanks, mate. And words just don't do it, but I really appreciate it, so thank you. Almost there. So the ladies in the kitchen. This is near enough the last part. Always put on a good feed. So, our ladies in the kitchen. First off, our grandparents. It's amazing to have 5 out of 8 and have 3 looking down on us. Both Aaron and I are very grateful to have you all in our lives. You're all amazing role models. And we look forward to many, many, many more years with you here. So thank you, and a special thanks to Pop for getting up under all the pressure in St. Grace, so thank you. To Troy and Jess, if you don't know Troy and Jess, you'll know them. Well, you'll definitely know Troy by the end of the night. It's often very hard. Oh, hello. It's often very hard to ask friends to do time-consuming jobs when they would probably prefer to be seated enjoying the time. I know it's hard, and on behalf of Aaron and I, I'd just like to really thank you and let you know we really appreciate what you did for us today. And words don't do you guys justice. You made this afternoon a lot of fun, no stress. And I hope you had a nice enough time too, so thank you very much to you too. Chris and Corinne and Paul and Ashram, I'm just going to do you all together. You're a very special group of four. Great to have you as really close friends. Great to know that we could ring you at midnight and say, can you do this, and you do it. Chris, a big thank you for jumping on board and setting up with Gina and getting up tonight. You guys were awesome from what I've heard and no doubt believe it. Thank you to Ash and Corinne for all the work on the lovely banners that went on the bus that probably no one else saw, but they were awesome. You girls are amazing, and Paulie, thanks for just being there, mate. And obviously, Paul and Usher, thank you in other ways. Just before I go on to the main person of the night, I'd just like to thank Mr. Old Red Bowtie over here. I'm a salesperson, but if you are single, it's a great catch. If I was a girl, I'd be pretty happy. But honestly, bro, if you didn't know, me, Karen and I got engaged. We weren't allowed to bring anyone until we saw both parents. After seeing my mum, we weren't going to tell anyone because we hadn't seen our siblings. Aaron proceeded to ring Lionel, who was in London, and say, basically, we got engaged, you are our MC, it's going to be awesome. And he went, yeah, I'm there. So, thanks for answering the call. Really appreciate it. And no doubt we'll sing some booze in the next couple of days. I won't name the Travers as I've alluded to them, but really appreciate all those people that travel far. Even those people that have overseas. What can I say? Thank you very much. Sorry, I'll finish now. To my wife on the left of me, lovely lady, very lovely lady. As she knows, I'm not a big fan of PDA. I don't like to show much public display of affection, but I'll try my best in the next 30 seconds. As a young man growing up in New Zealand, there were three things on my to-do list. First one was to have lots of money. I haven't won a lotto yet, but I think that's probably my only chance to get money. As you've probably heard, because teachers always go on about it, we never make much money. But that's fine, I've given that in, that's cool. The second goal was to be in Warwick. Always wanted to follow my grandfather, but as he said, it was never going to happen. As his soul. However, as I've said, there's a few clubs out there that are after my name, so or after my signature. So that goal's probably not up yet, but I'm going to say now it is. I've given up. I'm probably too good for it anyway. And I've got Aaron, so what more can I say? And the third thing was I've got here to have a hot missus, which was to get a girlfriend, obviously. I've definitely done that. Anyway. As the saying goes, third time lucky. Lucky for me, of course. I then tried to write all these adjectives to describe her in front of you, but I'll probably take up too much of your time. She's that fabulous. You're amazing. You're stunning. You're smart. You're sporty, which is a big one. You're caring. You're loving. And I guess you have the same goals that I have in life, which is awesome to come across. So I love you. I'm glad that you said yes when I asked you to get married with me on the 8th of September last year. I'm glad you turned up to the church today. These four idiots said she wasn't coming. I'm glad you went through with it. I guess to finish the last week, I've found it pretty hard to go to sleep at night. And there's been some reasons for that. Aaron's had a few nightmares or whatnot, and I've copped it with the guy that she's been giving a hiding to. But there's been other nights where she's done actually nothing wrong. And so I guess my sleeps in the last week have been pretty poor. And so I've tried to answer why I haven't been able to sleep. So the first one, as I've just said, the three goals, there's three again. Am I nervous? No, I wasn't nervous. I knew it was the right thing. Was I scared? Well, I guess you always are a little bit scared, but I'd be stupid to be scared to marry this lovely lady, so I wasn't scared. Was I excited? Well, yeah, I was really excited. I couldn't wait for Saturday to come, but it wasn't that. It can be simply said by something that I found late last night, early this morning from Dr. Zeus. Just on my phone. It said, you know you're in love when you can't fall asleep because reality is finally better than your dreams. This afternoon, my dream came true. Aaron, I love you, and I'm excited about our new chapter together. On that, I'd like to charge a toast. I don't even know how many to charge to. But let's just charge a toast. Yeah.